On the Health Watch tonight, flu season. It is officially weeks away, but there's already a lot of concern. It is getting attention from more than just doctors and medical researchers. Politicians are paying attention as well. Today, Governor Schwarzenegger issued a warning that 1 in 4 Californians, that's 9 million of us, will get swine flu. President Obama also taking on swine flu concerns today. With his medical advisors by his side, the president announced the government is prepared for an H1N1 outbreak, but Americans need to take steps to protect themselves.
I don't want anybody to be alarmed, but I do want everybody to be prepared. We know that we usually get a second, larger wave of these flu viruses in the fall, and so response plans have been put in place across all levels of government.
Part of the president's message, you've heard this before, you'll hear it again. To prevent swine flu, wash your hands, sneeze into your sleeve, and stay home if you're sick. Meantime, researchers in California are hoping to make a breakthrough on a vaccine. We'll get more on that from Action News reporter Phil Gomez, who is live in Santa Cruz.
Well, health officials could be battling both the swine flu and the seasonal flu this fall, and Stanford researchers are hoping to add something new to their arsenal to combat swine flu. They're seeking healthy adults to test a new swine flu vaccine mixed with an ingredient that could boost people's immune response to it. Stanford researchers want to determine whether combining the H1N1 swine flu vaccine with an immune system stimulating substance called an adjuvant will improve response to the vaccine.
We are trying to determine whether we can give perhaps fewer injections in order to fully immunize a person. It's also possible that we may learn that we can use the adjuvant to overcome some of the failure to develop an immune response, particularly in an elderly population.
Meanwhile, some people are seeking remedies off store shelves that they hope might prevent those flu-like aches and pains, like Tamiflu.
Lowers the intensity and maybe shortens the duration of the flu and swine flu.
But health experts repeat what they've been saying from the beginning. The best way to prevent infection and treat it doesn't come from drugstore shelves. The best methods of prevention are the simple ones. Proper hygiene, like washing hands frequently with soap, water, and covering your nose and mouth when coughing or sneezing.
I think everyone wants us to have a magic bullet, but actually, those good old-fashioned tried-and-true methods work. They really work.
Stanford is looking for 130 volunteers and want to begin the trial in about 2 weeks, depending on whether they get the green light from the National Institute of Health. Aaron and Dan.
All right, Phil, thank you. The Stanford study subjects will get the vaccine for free and will receive up to $300 for their participation, which would include several clinic visits.